It's less than 24 hours until Apple unveils us the new iOS 18. In this video, you're gonna know everything that you should be expecting in this developers conference and Apple's announcement. What's up, Lollipop? My name is Joe, and in today's video, let's talk about iOS 18. Not iPadOS, not macOS, not any of those. We're only focusing on iOS 18. Last minute details have come to light about this operating system, and I could not be more excited to talk about it and just to visualize what it's going to be like, because I'm like a child in Christmas. I cannot sleep. I cannot wait to see what Apple is going to bring us. First off, AI. Now, I know what you're thinking, artificial intelligence. No, Apple is not bringing us artificial intelligence, or not in a way that you might think. They have inked a deal with OpenAI, the founders of ChatGPT, the makers of ChatGPT. ChatGPT will be implemented in your iPhone. But that is not the AI part. The AI part is Apple intelligence. This is the most Apple thing I've ever heard from Apple, but they are calling their artificial intelligence their machine learning is changing to Apple intelligence, because everything that is going to happen on device will be Apple intelligence. Everything that is going to happen off device is going to be ChatGPT. That's why they needed to, you know, ink the deal with someone and have a partner in this. And that's why it isn't Google Gemini, because Gemini is Google. Yeah, I know it's a weird thing, but no, Apple didn't want their competitors, their main tech competitors, to be showcased in such a strong way in their new iOS operating system. A lot of news has come out that ChatGPT is superior to Gemini, which might be true. I'm not here to decide that. The fact is, Apple will be using ChatGPT for Siri probably, and for general queries that you need from the internet, and anything that is artificial intelligence, changing photos, transcriptions, and I could name a lot, that is going to happen on device thanks to Apple intelligence. But it's not only AI that's happening. We're gonna have new applications. New applications like mail, voice memos, notes, photos, messages. These are all getting major upgrades. Major upgrades with the implementations of artificial intelligence, or Apple intelligence. Now you know what it is. So the mail application is going to resemble the Gmail application. So the mail application will be able to read the emails and generate you answers or suggest content that you could reply to those. It could intelligently put them into different folders or basically just clean up your mailbox. Now the thing is, while Gmail does read your emails and looks through it and looks for keywords and then gives you advertisements, Apple intelligence will not. So they will only be using this on device. So ChatGPT and these things have no access to your private data. It's only Apple, and we know Apple's secure. Apple's one of the most secure companies in the world, and they want to keep it that way. We're gonna have a new Notes application. Notes application on the iPad is a favorite way of mine of writing down notes. I love the handwriting feature. I love a lot of things. Handwriting to text is amazing on there. But the best thing is, now it's gonna get a big upgrade. You're gonna be able to solve math problems. You're gonna be able to do a lot more in this application thanks to Apple intelligence. Apart from the notes, the voice memos, which is like visual notes, is getting an upgrade too. Just like last year with voicemail, visual voicemail, and transcriptions in voicemail, you're gonna be able to transcribe all of your voice memos instantly. And that begs the question, will that happen with videos too? If I shoot a video, will it be able to automatically transcribe every word that was said in that video? That would be fantastic. If it could generate me a text file from all of the clips that I do, that would make subtitles so much easier. But that's just my thing. Probably your thing is the Photos app, because in the Photos app, we will be able to generate photos, but not like what you're used to with the competitors. No, you're gonna be able to say, ah, that balloon is red, I want it purple. Your phone's gonna be able to do it. I wanna take the people out from the background, and your phone is going to be able to do it. These are the minor things that Apple's good at. They implement it in a way that is comfortable, that is good to use, that it's easy to use, easy to understand. You don't need to create new images. No, you are the artist. Create an image and let Apple help you fix it so it's perfect the way you wanted it to be. Apart from all of the applications that we already have, we're getting one new application, and that's the password application. In the password application, we're gonna have our passwords, exactly. But this is interesting because now the passwords live in the settings. this is coming out from the settings, it's going on your home screen, and not only your home screen, but on Android and on Windows and on Mac and everywhere. It's gonna have an authenticator built in. It's gonna be basically a rival or a competition for like LastPass or 1Password or these applications. Apple is going to take out the whole password from the settings and create a new app that you can use. You can change your passwords easily. You can update your passwords very easily, which is actually very handy. I got like 500 passwords right now that are saying like, oh no, it's insecure, you need to change. I'm too lazy to go through 500 passwords. Apple, help me. Please help me. Now, while this is coming to your home screen, another thing is coming to your home screen, and that is the ability to put the applications wherever you want. Yes, our Android friends have been living in this dream for a long, long time. Now we'll be able to customize our home screen the way we want. If you want an app to be down on the bottom and nothing on the top, you're gonna be able to do it. And themes are coming too. Exactly, you'll be able to change the color of each application. So if you want all of your app icons to be pink, because that's your vibe, then you're gonna be able to do it. And this integration of customization started 2-3 years ago. Last year, we got the whole contact cards. Now it's coming out from the contacts app and the phone app, and it's actually being implemented on your phone, on your home screen, on your lock screen. A much more customizable iPhone is coming our way. Some accessibility features were already announced from Apple. One being that you can control your iPhone and iPad with your eyes. Another one is a feature that if you get nausea when you're in the car and you're looking at your phone, Apple's gonna fix that. They're gonna put like little black dots on your screen when you're in a car, and if you know you brake, the dots go forward. This is actually for the motion. This is exactly against motion sickness. So your body doesn't feel that it's out of touch with the real world, and it's gonna help with nausea. But the big thing, the huge thing, Siri 2.0. It was the first and it's now the last. Without any doubt, Apple has to do something regarding Siri. And that's where ChatGPT comes in. Siri is going to be more conversation aware. Siri is gonna have a faster response time, it's gonna be more smarter, it's gonna understand you, it's gonna be able to recall things, it's gonna be able to put things in memory a way you don't think right now. If you ever spent time with ChatGPT and ChatGPT 4.0, then you know what you should expect with Siri 2.0. And that's a huge thing, because Apple with privacy needs to be very careful. It's their brand image. It's secure, it's safe. The way they're going to implement this, I don't know. But what I do know is it's going to be probably better than all of the other ones out there right now. I mean, I truly hope that they're not only playing catch up, but they're showing something unique to us. And based on interviews that we've seen with Apple execs in the past couple of months, whenever the AI or Siri or this question was raised to them, all they did was smile and say that they don't worry about anything. So with that confidence, I'm going into this show, I'll call it a show, to see something unique, to see something awesome. Which devices will get it? As in the previous months we've said before, it's still the same. iPhone XS, XS Max, XR, which was actually before XS. So XR, XS, XS Max, 11, 11 Pro, Pro Max, 12 Mini, 12, 12 Pro, 12 Pro Max, 13 Mini, 13, 13 Pro, 13 Pro Max, 14, 14 Plus, 14 Pro, 14 Pro Max, 15, 15 Plus, 15 Pro, and 15 Pro Max. These are the devices for iOS 18. For iPadOS, macOS, tvOS, watchOS, visionOS, homeOS, we don't know. Every iPhone that is running iOS 17 right now is going to get iOS 18. But the assistant features, or the top-of-the-line AI features, Apple Intelligence features, are not going to be available on all of the devices, probably only on the new iPhone 15 Pro and Pro Max. That is because these phones have the new A17 Pro chip.